What's going on, guys? We're back at it again. NCAA podcast. We got the game of the week here. I chose Tennessee versus Virginia Tech. This week was really tough, actually, to choose a game to do the simulation on. But I decided to go with Tennessee versus Va Tech because they have the, they're playing in the, what's the name of it? I can't even think of the name of it right now. The racetrack. Obviously, you guys know I don't watch NASCAR. They're playing at the NASCAR stadium, a Bristol Motor Speedway. It is in Tennessee. That's why I chose the Liberty Bowl Stadium, which is also in Tennessee, to try to give that neutral game kind of feel. It's fielded at the two. Oh my gosh, that was terrible. And I think that's Eric Berry's little brother there. Also, Tennessee, I'm 90% sure is Nike now. So that's a little bit different. But this week, not as dope as last week. And there were some big upsets. Houston won, which Houston won. He saw a break in the defense and just Texas won, which I did pick. Florida State barely squeaked out with that win. I thought they were going to lose for sure. It was crazy. Crazy week happened. Lots of crazy stuff. USC got murdered, which I did not see happening. Under heavy pressure. And they got it. Ooh, shout out to the homie Dobbs. That dude was not on top of him. That was just like a random simulation that they decided. Pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
From their own 24-yard line. Third down.
Okay, what do we got here? Let's start it off with the Pac-12 picks. I'm hyped. BYU. Oh, are you kidding me? That was ridiculous. Super hyped that BYU beat U of A. F those guys. UCLA did lose to Texas A&M. I'm kind of upset about that one in overtime. Kind of sucked.
He's on the run. He's taken down at the 18-yard line.
But let's go ahead and go through the Pac-12 picks really fast. We'll save the ranked games. We won't do the ranked games inside of the Pac-12 picks. We'll do those later. So we got Utah State versus the 0-1 USC at USC. USC is going to smash them. Let's go, boy. Shout out to the homie, Obnoxious Skeezer. If you're looking for Happy Wars gameplay, that dude is a savage. Hit him with that pitch. Dobbs supposed to be the next coming, but he hasn't panned out too well. Tennessee almost lost to Appalachian State in overtime. They barely won. So
it's fourth down.
That's kind of crazy.
They'll call on the field goal unit here.
We got USC versus Utah State. We're going with
Tennessee.
Those Trojans.
Is looking fight to go
on.
Up by three.
Next, we got Idaho State versus Colorado. Colorado is undefeated. They did beat Colorado State. Shout out to the homie Colorado. Let's go to the next one. BYU versus Utah. This is that Mormon battle. This is a rivalry game. Mormon battle. We going at it back and forth. We're going with the Utah Utes. We're repping the pack. I was a big BYU fan last week, but this week, rocking with Utah. UCLA versus UNLV. Got to go with the Bruins, baby. West Coast, best coast. Dude, that dude got shimmy.
Somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers.
We're going
have
with
to take some of the pressure
UCLA
off
in the Rose Bowl.
Really make a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
Next, we got Washington State versus Boise State. Cougars did lose week one to Eastern Washington. I'm very upset about that. It's freaking ridiculous. It's terrible. They're going to lose to Boise State. Going with Boise State. I know it sucks, but I got to do it. Got to go with Boise. Next, we got Cal versus San Diego State in San Diego. Why is Cal going to San Diego? Who knows?
Scrambling around.
down. Let's go, boy. They'll bring him down. Jared Evans, a homie. Gerard Evans. Got a nice little Russian. I'm going to go with Cal. Hopefully they come through. I know Cal's not going to be that good after losing Goff. Oh, wrecked. But I'm going to go with Cal. Rip the pack. Virginia versus Oregon is a big game. Power 5 team versus Power 5 team. Going with Oregon. Quack, quack. Next game is U of A versus Grambling State. F U of A. And the final Pac-12 game of the night, which is actually not the latest game. I guess our game's at 5. Or no. 7. That makes sense. It's at Sunnyvale Stadium. You know I'll be there. It's going to be over 100 degrees. And I'm going to be hot as balls. But it's going to be lit AF. Texas Tech versus my Arizona State Sun Devils. You already know who I'm going with. Go Devils, boy. We're going with that dub for the Devils. In our newly remodeled, half-remodeled stadium, which I'm not really about. I wasn't the biggest fan, but they look decent against the NAU, so they can come through against Texas Tech. Texas Tech's going to be tough, though. Not going to be easy. That's all the Pac-12 games, other than the one ranked game. Stanford apparently doesn't have a game, so whatever. There's only two ranked Pac-12 teams right now. That's kind of weak. Mostly because Tennessee, the LA teams have both won. I guess there's three. Oregon. Forgot to take Oregon out of the picks, but they were ranked 24. I didn't really notice. So whatever. And he tackles them hard at the 44. And they were lucky that okay. one didn't go for tonight's more. Game. Like they've never defended the option. The only ranked game of the night is Syracuse versus Louisville. Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes. Right around the 48. I'm going to go with Louisville. They're number 13. It's at Syracuse in the Carrier Dome, so you know it gets rocking in there. But I'm going to definitely go with Louisville on this one. They're pretty good, and they are the only hope to knock Houston out of the playoff. So,
and he's taken down around the 33-yard line.
Now he took the pitch there and was able to get the
okay,
first
next game we got down the list. Central Michigan versus Oklahoma State in Stillwater. Boom Pickens Stadium. Power 5 versus non-Power 5. Gotta go with the Power 5 team all the time. At home, at least. Oklahoma State over Central Michigan. You guys already know. Josh Dobbs with the 4-for-4 with the 75 passing yards. Let's go, boy.
First down grab. And they make the stop at the 21. From the 21-yard line. First down.
Dang, sacked.
He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Number 8 on the drive. They're driving. Okay, let's get back to it. Perry A&M versus Texas A&M. Texas A&M, let's be real. And it's at home.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
Jalen Hurd. That sounds familiar. What's the name of
Tennessee
Alabama's quarterback?
Is up a field goal.
I'm going to double check this.
To the receiver, incomplete. A tight, low-scoring game in that first 15 minutes. Let's
Jalen
see
Hurts.
Things open up in the second quarter.
Jalen Hurd versus Jalen
the Volunteers
Hurts.
With a three-point lead. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2.
Quarter number 2. Let's go with Nichols versus Georgia in Athens.
It's up, and it is good.
And there we go. Just 2 field goals for Tennessee so far. Shout out to Smokey the Dog.
The kicker looks
pretty
like
sure
he's
that's
ready
his name. I'm not 100% sure of that.
He sends this one deep. And it goes into
but
the
we got the Georgia Bulldogs. Nick Chubb carrying the load. What a savage this guy is, Nick Chubb.
Momentum
I'm going to go with
him. Fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be
let's go to
UCF
versus
plays.
Michigan. Michigan. We're going with Michigan, baby. Away. They're too strong. They're too strong.
Second down and 10 to go.
Lamar versus Houston. Houston going to destroy him. Let's just keep on rolling on that one. Troy. Let's get that.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Tackle made at about the 29-yard line.
Troy versus Clemson. Clemson, number two team in the country. I feel like they should have dropped. I don't agree with them being this high after their squeak by of a victory. But gotta go with Clemson. There's no way they're losing to Troy. That would be unbelievable.
And he's gonna come up with a sack. The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Okay, next.
Sutton, the return man.
That's a good good stop there for Tennessee. Heading into the top of the second quarter here.
Tackle at the 49.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals.
Can't settle for field goals,
Cap. They settle for field goals.
Can't settle for field goals.
The defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Next we got.
Got some open field. He makes his way out to about the 35.
God's coming through.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This
next
guy
we got Charleston
air,
Southern versus Florida State. Florida State's going to murk these schools. That's not even close.
Has some daylight.
Dobbs coming through.
He's at the 20. He gets hit out of bounds. Right around.
Okay, next we got Akron versus Wisconsin. I'm going to go with Wisconsin. This is at home at Camp Randall Stadium. You've got to go with Wisconsin. Wisconsin pulled off the huge upset. That's the one I was forgetting. Wisconsin beat LSU. My national champion pick team with Leonard Fournette. They went up into Green Bay and lost to Wisconsin. That was mind-blowing to me. They could have won this game. Their quarterback is straight trash. It's crazy.
The 10. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
But Wisconsin, I guess, is just that stout defense, that Big 12, big boys defense.
Touchdown, Volunteers.
Finally.
Call here inside the 5-yard line. The defense took
Tennessee
the
comes through with the score.
Great read,
and they're starting to blow this game out. This is not the game of the week. Well, maybe it is. We've had two blowouts so far in our simulation game of the weeks. It makes sense, though, because Florida That makes sense because Alabama is just way too good.
Is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
So our score, 13-0.
13-0, getting smashed.
For a touchback, Virginia Tech's offense is so predicated on what this wide receiver does, and now when you consider that we've got a couple of quarters left, they've got to change the complexion.
They got to throw it to Ford. I don't know who that is, what number he is.
This is where a coaching staff gets challenged because
Is that him? Is that Ford? No, Bucky Hodge.
And you have a good idea of how you want to attack the defense.
Okay, next we got SMU versus Baylor in Waco. Got to go with Baylor. They looked really good. They murdered whoever they played, some of the garbage teams. We're going with Baylor. SMU, though, they're not something to sneeze at. I think they could have a chance, but this is at Baylor. If this was the other way, even neutral, I might be able to go with SMU, but I'm going with Baylor. Nevada versus Notre Dame. Notre Dame lost to Texas, which I did pick that one, but that was on the road. DeShone Kizer looked lit. He threw for 5 touchdowns. He's a good quarterback. I'm going with Notre Dame Fighting Irish. They're going to beat Nevada. Let's go! Ooh, that dude got wrecked. Next, we got Western Kentucky versus Alabama. You guys already know the Crimson Tide. Roll Tide in Bryant-Denny Stadium. Tulsa versus Ohio State. O-H-I-O. We're going with the Ohio State. Shout out to the homie, Urban Meyer. Tim Tebow's daddy. We got Ohio State coming through on that one. Wofford versus Ole Miss. Ole Miss did lose. They lost to Florida State. I thought they should have won that game. Chad Kelly looked really good. They just kind of tricked it off at the end. But I'm going to go with Ole Miss to destroy Wofford. I like Ole Miss. I wouldn't be shocked if they beat Alabama again this year, because that's kind of just what they do. They're full of extremely talented players. Shout out to the boy Robert Kimbici. Bird game, we out here. Next, we got Idaho versus UW, University of Washington. Gotta go with the Huskies. Shout out. This game is in Husky Stadium. That's where I did get engaged to my beautiful wife. And I love her very much. And Washington always has a special place in my heart because of that. The ASU Washington game. We won, but it was like a hurricane. But we won. Shout out to the Devils coming through with that dub in Husky Stadium. Yeah, I told my girl, if we didn't win, you ain't getting this ring. Well, I didn't tell her then, but like I told her after the fact. I was like, thank God they won, because you weren't getting the ring if they didn't. But yeah, I'm hyped.
The kick is away. It's long enough.
Nailed it.
He got it.
Watek cuts it to 10, baby. They cut it to 10, boy. Here at Bristol Motor Speedway, even though we're in Memphis, Tennessee. Next, we got Florida Atlantic versus the Miami Hurricanes. What about them Hurricanes, boy? Check out. Oh, that dude just died. I think he's dead. I think that dude literally just died on the field. Light it up.
Kind of having their way against this defense.
There's this dope rap song. It's called Them Hurricanes or something like that. It's by this dude, Arturo. Arturo something. It's on YouTube. You can watch it. And it's just a really funny rap song. And they're talking about, like, different hurricanes, dude. Ed Reed, all that kind of stuff. Them Hurricanes, boy. Definitely check it out. It's really dope. Next, we got Louisiana Monroe. From the bio, coming down to Norman, Oklahoma. Oklahoma's going to destroy these boys. Even though they did lose last week, they're going to destroy freaking whoever that trash team was, I just said. We got UTEP versus Texas coming in to Austin. I don't see Texas having that letdown after that.
About the 33-yard line.
But they could. I'm just going to go with Texas here. I don't think that they're going to lose just yet. I don't think that they're going to, like, go undefeated or anything.
He's got room. Tackle around the 46-yard line.
But I'm not picking them to lose yet to, like, UTEP.
Gets out to around the 45.
Okay, next we got Arkansas versus TCU. This was another nominee for game.
Tennessee's going to have to use their second time out of the half. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 40.
Two Power 5 teams going against each other. It isn't happening much this week. A lot of those matches were last week, and they were ranked versus ranked. Now we got ranked versus another Power 5. Arkansas has always been a solid team. They didn't look good week one, but they did come through with a win. And they did look good last year. And like in the past couple years, they've been competing in the SEC. That dude didn't even land on the ground, so who's picking him up? I don't know.
Play number 9 of this current drive.
But I'm going to go with TCU. It's in Dallas / Fort Worth, whatever. TCU is the home team. It's on campus. I'm going with TCU.
Quick strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down around the 18-yard line.
Box two.
Next, we got Iowa versus Iowa State. We got to go with the Hawkeyes. It's at Iowa. They hate Iowa State. Let's go, Hawkeyes. They're ranked. They're good. Iowa State has already lost this season. We're going with Iowa. LSU versus Jacksonville State in Baton Rouge.
Swings it out there incomplete. And there wasn't anyone.
You gotta go with LSU.
I think the ball just slipped out on
him. Yo, Tigers. That's the homies right there. Shout out to Patrick Peterson, Bird Gang. And who's the other guy?
He's on the run. Fumble.
Dang. This dude just fumbled it right at the 2-yard line. But yeah, shout out to Patrick Peterson and Tyron Matthew. The Honey Badger coming through. The Badger, boy. And then we got Virginia versus Oregon. We already went with them. Shout out to the boy Marcus Mariota. Yo, these fools better just to run the clock out. What are they doing?
And he tackles him hard at the 3-yard line.
Okay. They got the stop. They're hyped about it.
They
got
the
turnover.
We head to the break. Still plenty of time left in this one.
Plenty of time.
Tennessee's got a 10-point lead.
But,
glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show.
NCAA 14, even though it's now 16.
That excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. This first half is the one that's kept us busier in the studio than any other. Every other game around the country wanting constant updates from this potential upset that's brewing right now. Sort of capture the fancy.
I don't know about this.
Oh, man, my phone's blowing up. Everybody's like, what's going on? How is this possible? We never saw it coming, but it's happening. And it's one of those weeks in college football where we always talk about you better.
I don't really think that was an accurate analysis over here by David Pollack. Pretty sure that was David Pollack, at least. Sounded like him. Shout out to the homie David Pollack one time, Georgia Bulldogs.
Goes into the end zone, down for a
last back. Game we got here is Vatek versus Tennessee, your featured matchup.
There's got to be some sense of urgency
the Volunteers,
this right
even
now.
Though they looked pretty trash last week, and they should have lost to a 1AA opponent if that team didn't miss field goals and stuff. Got to go with them. So maybe I need to rethink my final four teams from my initial prediction show, because LSU is not looking too great.
This one will fall incomplete.
You know, Brad, the Stanford still looks nice good. They the still smashed some hoes. Everybody's in position to be able to make the play. The only problem
the only
is
problem
they didn't intercept
was
the football.
Just,
that's something that they got to be happy with the coverage, but not happy with the result.
LSU lost.
This defensive lineman's got the kind of size and strength where he can disrupt the play all by himself.
Sutton will be the return man.
ASU didn't get any votes. Appalachian State got a vote when they lost. That's funny.
Sutton fields at the 29.
Look at this
top 25
to see if ASU got any votes now. You're still so USC still getting.
So they're
some
just
votes.
About set
That's
to get
crazy.
The game going again.
I don't think Clemson really deserved to be number two after what happened.
Throws it in a hurry, and he's taken down right around the 38-yard line. That brings up second and
nine. Let's see if we'll watch this real quick and see if Virginia Tech can make a little bit of a comeback. Shout out to them Hokies, boy.
He gets out to about the 48-yard line, and the halfback carries for a pickup of three.
That makes it fourth and inches.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one.
Oh, they're coming for it? Vatek trying to get that comeback? Comeback season?
He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and ten.
It's second and ten. Ball on the 20-yard line. He throws.
Oh, boy.
Junior makes the catch.
Oh, breaks it.
Inside the 30. And they finally push him out at the 17-yard line.
First
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's a game of four. Let's go. They're mounting this comeback. They're only down 10. They can score a touchdown here. Then they'll only be down 3 or 7. Oh, that's not going anywhere. Travon McMillan. Jalen Reeves Maben. Dang, that's some pursuit right there. People talk about this Tennessee team as a Final Four contender, as a SEC East champion. They didn't look too good so far. Shout out to them Gators, though. Or them Georgia Bulldogs. Might have a little bit something to say about that. They're only getting 3. The defense did hold them to 3, so we're going to go here and see what happens with this field goal. There it goes. Lit.
Virginia Tech gets set to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 27-yard line.
Virginia Tech's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time.
Let's go, defense. Tennessee. I'm kind of hyped. I want Vaught Tech to come back. Dobbs ain't about it, though. You better watch out, because he already fumbled once, fam. Cost his team some points.
And they make the stop at the 45-yard line. To him before he could get back to the line.
A loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings up 3rd and 10.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. Throws it to the outside.
Oh, boy.
Jenny was the intended
gotta catch that one, boy. So fourth down, though.
Now they'll have to punt.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Daniel is waiting for the snap.
Punt.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty.
Dang, right into the end zone, though.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to
shout out to the homie with the 93 one time. With that D-line number.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
There you go, boy. Nice run. That's a good first down run right there. Travon McMillan. He's only averaging 3.8. He just ripped off 7 one time. 1, 2, 3. Not some 7, but almost 7. Let's go. Another 7. That looked more like 5, but we'll give him 7. First down.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
One tack.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on 34. It's the tailback.
Turn up field.
Nice run to the left there.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
Mike 34. Makes the grab and steps out.
Let's
right
go,
away.
Boy.
Gain of 14 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
Come on. If you put that ball on his back shoulder, he can at least catch it, turn up the field a little bit.
That'll make it 7-7.
That's just a mistake. Keeps it.
They'll drop him for a loss.
Ooh, that dude said, I want to eat, boy. He said, feed me.
And here's another third down.
He said, feed me, though.
He airs it out.
Woo! Oh, he dropped it. That's a touchdown. The DBs are hyped, even though they didn't do anything. Oh, they're putting it away.
He's gonna try to cough and corner this one.
You better cough and corner it.
This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. And folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. Tennessee's lead is a touchdown.
Come on, let's go, Vatek. They should have scored on that last drive. That was a good ball. Right in into that fourth quarter. Ooh, they got them fours up, though. Them fans got them fours up, though.
It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter.
This is it right here. Get that three and out, Vatek. You need it. There we go. Hold them to like one or two yards.
He's got nowhere to go.
Shout out to the homie Josh Smith. Dropped it.
Open and he can't pull it in. From their own 21-yard line, it's third down. Over the middle to his tailback. He's tackled around the 23-yard line. That's a gain of two on the play. Johnson is back awaiting the punt. Brought down at the 37-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way.
Let's see if Vatek can come through, make a like a final drive here.
Now he tries to buy
some
time.
He's got a nice little run there.
Watching the NFL game last night was hype.
Watching college football last week was super hype. The Texas game was a lot of fun to watch. The Florida State game was a lot of fun to watch. I went to the ASU game. It wasn't that fun because it was close for a little bit. But after that, it was fun because then we just like started murking them.
And they get nice yardage on that run. First down. Quick pass. He's taken down right around the 36-yard line.
Brings up second and nine.
Hey, check Mike 34. Mike 34.
Here we go. Orange line.
Steps up into the pocket and they've got it. Third down now and they need to get it to the 26. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He might not be able to get the pass.
Woo! Making plays, boy.
That's a great tackle at the 21. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wide outs. He's scrambling.
What a little stiff arm from the boy, Gerard Evans.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Just under three to go in regulation.
Oh, Oh, he's fighting for it. Oh, Frig.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
This is the 10th play of this drive. He scrambled. Slides down to the ground.
Third and goal. They need to score.
And he throws it away. Well, we got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
Oh, that's not Hurd's anymore. Hurd? I don't know what his name.
Here we go from the seven. It's fourth down.
I don't remember his name at all.
Scrambling around. He lost the ball. But he
oh my gosh. These fools drive down to the 1 yard line and fumble.
This defense here. Great play by the linebacker to come up with the ball after the fumble.
Teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He's to the 10. And he's tackled at about.
What? No! The game just went out! Well, that about wraps it up, guys. We're going to go with the victory from the Tennessee Volunteers. That was crazy. I'll see you guys next time. You guys already know what it is. Go Devils.